If you're a streamer and you're not using the replay buffer, you are wasting hours of your time. Over the past 7 years of streaming, I've wasted so much time by either scrubbing my VODs for clips after I ended, or screaming at chat to clip things and risk missing those epic moments. But forget dealing with all those problems. Let me show you right now how to bypass all that BS and how to start using the replay buffer in OBS Studio or Streamlabs to start capturing high quality clips in real time. And I got a special tip for you guys at the very end of the video, so make sure to watch until the end. Step one, open up OBS Studio or Streamlabs. It's pretty much the same process for either, but I will point out some key differences. First thing you should notice is this beautiful starting soon screen, which if you don't have one, you can grab it in my streamer starter pack, link in the description down below. But you guys might notice that I have a button that says Start Replay Buffer right here, which you probably don't. So the first thing we need to do is actually go into the settings of OBS or Streamlabs. And then what we're gonna go and do is click on the Output tab right here. And if you're on the simple mode, you can actually scroll down and see it at the very bottom where it says Replay Buffer. You're gonna wanna make sure this is checked. And if you're not on simple mode, you're on advanced, it'll be located actually right here. Just make sure to enable the replay buffer by ensuring that it is checked on whether you're on advanced or simple. It doesn't matter, just make sure it's checked. So you'll notice first that it has a maximum replay time. This simply just means how long the clip is gonna be after we tell it to clip something. You can have it anywhere between 10, 5 seconds, or recommended around 30 all the way up to about 4 minutes, which would be 240 seconds. However, if you do anything longer than that, you might as well just do a normal recording instead. I usually like to keep mine around 30 to 60 seconds, mainly because I want to usually post these to Instagram Reels, TikTok, or YouTube Shorts. So usually I like to keep it at about 60 seconds, so that way it's not going to be over a minute, especially after I'm done editing it for TikTok or Instagram Reels or wherever. So this one's pretty easy. This is just the length of the clip when we press our hotkey, which I'll show you how to do in a second. Now the maximum memory, you're not going to see this option if you're using Streamlabs, but basically this is just going to depend on how much RAM you have on your system. You could leave it at 512 megabytes and see how it goes, but the internet suggests that you keep it between about 1 gigabyte, which would start at 1024 megabytes, and 4 gigabytes, which would be 4096 megabytes. So depending on the strength of your computer and how much RAM you have, you can keep it between there, but truthfully, you can always start at 512, and if you're not happy with the quality of your recordings or if you're running into issues, you can experiment between 1 gigabyte and 4 gigabytes. So for this video, I'm going to keep it at 1 gigabyte, which is 1024 megabytes. And if you want more details on that, I'll leave a more detailed guide linked in the description down below, because I know this can go over some people's heads, but try not to get too overwhelmed with it. So now that we've enabled the replay buffer and we've set up our settings, we're going to hit apply. And that's when you're going to see the start replay buffer button appear in your controls on OBS Studio or Streamlabs. Now, if you're on Streamlabs, it's actually going to be right next to the go live button. I'll put a picture on the video right here showing you exactly what it looks like. But there's a couple more things that we need to do to really take advantage of the maximum effect of the replay buffer. The next thing we need to do is actually going to the advanced tab. We're going to scroll all the way down to where it says hotkeys, and we're going to make sure that the hotkey focus behavior says never disable hotkeys, so that way you don't run into any issues when we set up our hotkey to tell OBS or Streamlabs to save the replay buffer clip. So make sure that says never disable hotkeys, click apply. Now this is where the magic happens. This is where we're going to set our hotkeys. So anytime we press a hotkey, it's going to actually save the clip. So we're going to navigate over to the hotkeys tab here, and this is where a lot of people get confused, so pay attention. First, you're going to navigate to where it says start replay buffer and stop replay buffer. You would think that this is the one that controls when you actually take the clip, right? Well, you'd be wrong, and you're not the only one, because there's a lot of people. All this hotkey is going to do is going to turn this button on to enable you to then scroll down and use replay buffer save replay. This hotkey right here is the button you're going to hit in order to save that 60 second clip that we told it to under the output tab, which is right here. So if you want to have a hotkey set for turning the actual replay buffer on and off, you can. I think it's a little confusing to do that, so I don't. And there's also a setting if you go to general here where you can automatically start the replay buffer when streaming. So if we hit that and then we hit apply, anytime we're streaming and it says start streaming, it's automatically going to start the replay buffer, which does most of the work for us. That being said, you do not need to be streaming or recording to actually use the replay buffer at all. So if you just want to game offline with your friends and just clip hunt, you could totally do that. All you have to do is just click on start replay buffer like this. And then when we set our hotkey, you'll be able to take clips without streaming or recording, which I know a lot of people had questions questions about. However, if this replay buffer is not active, which it currently is, so if we turn it off like that and it's not, and you press your hotkey to save the actual replay, it's not gonna do nothing. So in order to actually save those clips and use the replay buffer, we'll go to hotkeys. We'll scroll down to where it says replay buffer, save replay. So this is where I like to use my poverty stream deck, because if you're familiar, I have a keyboard that has a little number pad like many of you probably do. And so this number pad can actually have up to like 9-10 plus keys because they're different than the actual numbers. On my keyboard, I just have to make sure the numlock key is turned on. So I enable the numlock. And then now if I press the 9 key on my number pad, which is to the right of my keyboard, and not the 9 above the actual letters where you type, I'm gonna press it right now. It's gonna say number pad 9, which is different than if I backspace that right there and I press the 9 above the letters, that's just a 9. So this way, if you have the numlock enabled, at least for my keyboard, yours might be different, then allowing that numlock to be on and pressing the numbers on the numpad, it's a completely set of different keys that you can use instead of shelling out a couple $100 for a Stream Deck. Now I know a Stream Deck is a lot more complicated and complex, advanced, do a lot more stuff with it, but for those people that are balling on a budget like your boy right here, the number pad is gonna work completely fine for majority of things that you need. So that's why we're gonna set it to number pad 9 here for save replay, hit apply, and then okay. And then now we have our start replay buffer here, which if we press number pad 9 right now, it's not gonna record anything because it's not actually enabled. So if you have that settings button under general, automatically start replay buffer when streaming is enabled, and you hit start streaming when you're live, this will also be turned on. However, if you wanna do it when you're recording or just do it by itself, you'll just simply press the key, or you can set that hotkey under hotkeys and then start replay buffer, stop replay buffer. But I think that complicates things, so I just like pressing the button itself. And then now if we press the 9 key, which I'm gonna do right now, it's gonna take the last 60 seconds of our whatever, and it's going to save it as a clip. So if you actually go to the file button in the top left corner and then click on show recordings, it's gonna actually pop up your little videos folder where all of your replays are saved. So you can see right here, we got a couple of replays because I was testing this out before the video. Now, obviously if you watch it, it's just the starting soon screen because that's what's active on our little OBS screen or Streamlabs screen. However, if you notice, this video is only 13 seconds long, but why is that the case if we set it to 60 seconds? Well, actually stump me for a second. It's because the replay buffer button just got turned on 13 seconds ago. So obviously if you're trying to record before that, it ain't gonna happen because we didn't tell it to turn on the replay buffer until after that. If you're not dumb like me, then you'll know that if you press this and it's active for more than 60 seconds, and then you go and actually press your button, it's gonna record the full 60 seconds. There's a lot of little intricacies just like that that can trip you up as a new streamer. But luckily you got your boy to make the fails before you do, so that way you don't get a headache like I do. And speaking of headaches, if you want to avoid all the headaches that come with becoming a streamer and learning all the ropes on everything you need to do to become a pro streamer, then check out my free streamers masterclass, which is linked in the description down below. Just pop your name and email here and you can click to watch the free masterclass where I cover everything you're going to need to know when you get started. But as far as the replay buffer, all of the video quality settings will mimic what you have under your output settings. So if you want to make any adjustments to that, just go to your output settings, whether you're on simple or advanced, and you'll make adjustments under the recording tab, or if you're on simple, just the recording tab here as well. And if you're ready to start getting more viewers and start growing your brand and channel as a streamer or content creator, then start watching this playlist to the side of me. It covers everything that you'll need to know in terms of growing your stream, especially when it comes to taking clips like this and turning them into more discoverable content on YouTube, TikTok, and more. So binge that playlist. My name's Cody, and I will see you in the next one.